Generally, if you were in an English chair shop, after using the travishing iron, craftsmen would generally then go on to use what's known as a stock scraper. Rectangular scraper set inside a two-piece wooden handle, split along the length, and presses on the scraper from the back with a couple of screws connecting the two halves. And throat chip clearance. It's quite a useful tool. Does a very nice job of finished shaping. I suppose the one drawback is that it doesn't leave a suitable final finish on the wood. It's kind of, just say, a little bit rough feeling. Grain gets raised up a little bit by scraping. So people generally, I suppose, would beyond this point, finished sanding would be the final step. I don't much use stock scraper. I prefer to use Japanese round bottom planes, of which I have a good variety. You generally, when people purchase these, or a few folks make them from scratch themselves, but they're sold either as a totally square rectangular block, or they already have a curve along the length. People who use them generally tend to want to reshape them to their liking, for whatever purpose they're going to be used for. For chair seats, you have the curve along the length, but you also want a curve across the width. This way, slight curve to get in the contours around the edges of the seat. Some are bit more curved than others, smaller, larger. The blades are curved accordingly to match the shape of the body. You do that yourself, usually with a grinder and then sharpening stones. So these heavier ones tend to be for deeper shaping, and some chair makers in Japan aren't familiar or use the travishing iron, so they use these from scratch, and take a pretty heavy shaving with them. Most of the ones I have do not have a sub blade or chip breaker. They're mainly designed for planing across the grain in this direction, and so you don't end up with tear out. You can use them with the grain, depending on species of wood and the tendency to tear out or not. For planing with the grain, there are this type has a sub-blade, so people who use hand planes will know that sub-blade is really helpful in preventing tear out as you're planing against the direction of the grain. Tendency to tear out is eliminated to a large extent by the having a sublade, but they are a little, well, basically slower planing tool, and I only use this type in the very final step, where it leaves a certain amount of tool marks, which I like. I tend to leave them in there and for the finished chair. So I've done most of the basic shaping with my trebuchet iron, and now I'll just, I don't know if it's visible in the video, there's a fine pencil line running around the seat, the edge of the contour, and I just like to plane right up to the edge and leave it. And just some spots are still a little deeper than others, and some problems with evenness yet, so I generally do the more refined planing with these tools, and it gives you a lot of control and fits your hands nicely, and they leave the effect that I'm looking for. So this is a bound up. This is a long piece of cloth that is wound up and set inside this piece of bamboo, and occasionally it's oiled and run the plane bottom across it, and it gives a bit of lubrication to the wood. Not really a very thick residue. It doesn't leave any indication on the wood, but it just, the planes will slide a little bit better across the wood. So I can, I don't know if it's evident in the video, but I can just plane right up to the edge of my line, and it leaves a nice crisp, sharp point of transition from the flat into the beginning of the curve. Really, a lot of control with these great tools. So with the smaller plane, you can get right up into a tight curve. Give yourself a nice fair line. So there you have it with regard to how I shape these seats. Once again, just to show, I have a whole bunch of different sizes and different shapes. A few have cap irons, most are just a single blade. Not only for chair seats, but any number of woodworking applications, these round bottom Japanese planes are really useful. And see, this is generally the tool I use for the final shaping, planing with the grain. Leaves a wavy shape, but basically the inner shape is even, and it's important points of where things should be flatter and where you want a little more curve for the comfort aspect. So these just enable you to shape the way you like, the way you like to, and just really, really great tool.